Chanel, how are you guys doing? Today we are going to be talking about an important topic because that is what I want, you know, to guide me throughout 2018. If you've been riding with me from the start on this channel, you would know one of my first videos was about slay queens. That video went bananas, like you guys, oh my god. I know I went crazy on that video. Let's just say 2017 was the year of, you know, slay queen, baddie, Instagram baddie, this, that. 2018 is the year for girl bosses, you know. It doesn't make sense for you to be a slay queen here, slay queen there. I read a post on Facebook actually where somebody said you can't be walking around with an investment. That investment was literally like hair, you know, extensions, when you can use that money to start up a business. So yeah, that's what this video is about today. I got this inspiration from like a huge girl boss, the founder of Nasty Girl, Sophia Amoruso. I think that's her name. I'll write it down somewhere in this video. Oh my gosh, she founded Nasty Girl. It's an online retail company when she was 22. Like, I'm telling you guys, 22. So she equally like wrote a book, and the title was Girl Boss. It's like, you know, how to be a girl boss. And I'm going to be sharing my top best quotes from that book, because I think, you know, this quote will guide you on how to go about your year and just be the best girl boss you can possibly be. So the first quote that really, really marked me from her book was this one: the energy you expend focusing on someone else's life is better spent working on your own. Just be your own idol. This quote just screams focus. Be focused on your own lane, work on yourself, be your own idol. The second quote, which I absolutely loved from that book, was this one: there are secret opportunities hidden inside failure. If there's one thing I would like to tell you is I've learned that failure is part of success. Failing at my YouTube channel, being frustrated, filming a video and at the end realizing my camera was not even recording or it stopped recording in the process, and I cry and I have to do it all over again, that has been part of the process. And yes, it has helped me to be patient. I've learned how to be patient. So what I would say about this particular quote is, there's always, I definitely agree with her, there's always success hidden inside failures. The third one, this one is juicy. You don't get taken seriously by asking someone to take you seriously. You have got to show up and own it. If this is a man's world, who cares? I'm still really glad to be a girl in it. What does this quote tell you? Action speaks louder than words. You've got to show up and own it. No excuses. 2018, if you want to be a girl boss, show up, own that shit. So yeah, the fourth quote is, I buy this definitely. One of the best books I've read was by George S. Clason, The Richest Man in Babylon. I've not read this book. Like, I need to get this book. I'm interested in reading this book. She goes ahead to say, which offers financial advice in a collection of parables. What does this tell you? Girl bosses read. They read books. If you want to, if you want to add meaning to your life, if you want to grow intellectually, spiritually, you've got to read. Take 2018, pick up a book. Don't leave your house without a book. Read, girls. Read, read. You're going to, the year would end with you just being so, I don't know, just so much of a better person. Personally, I'll say yes, it works. I've been reading, and that practice alone changed my life. So yeah. What next? Okay, yeah, the fifth quote I loved was, learn how to take care of yourself so that the man you marry is the man you choose to be with and not just the man who will take care of you. Like, does this scream independence to you? I love me an independent woman, you know. Don't get me wrong, I'm not saying the man shouldn't be the man in the marriage and stuff like that, but I need to own my own. I need to have my own. I need to be able to contribute into this thing. So yeah, girl bosses in 2018, we are going to be independent girls. The sixth quote is this one. And the shitty jobs make the good ones more meaningful. Praise be to Jesus, I relate. Most people don't land their dream job right away out of the gate, which means we all have to start somewhere. Humble beginnings. That's what I'll say. I started, this one is really, it's really, really emotional for me because starting my channel, like I uploaded the first video, how many subscribers did I get? I don't think I was up to 100. Yeah, at what, 800 plus subscribers in less than 6 months. Humble beginnings, I tell you. My first video was crappy. Like, you know, it was not the best quality camera, everything. My heart was racing throughout that video, but look at my today. I'm sitting here relaxed, chatting like I'm talking to my best friend. Humble beginnings. Don't put off starting, going after your dreams or starting a business or whatever because you are scared of, you know, you're scared to start. Humble beginnings will take you to greater places. Like, I'm a living testimony when it comes to this particular quote. So yeah, sorry, I'm so sorry I got emotional. The last quote is this one. During the miserable cab ride back home, I realized that I put up so much energy into thinking about what I didn't want to happen, that I had caused that exact thing to happen. I conjured that bitch. How many of you have done this? Because I'm a pro when it comes to this. And what does this teach you? The power of positive thinking. I have told myself I am going to think positively throughout this year, no matter what life throws at me. Like, I had not even finished telling myself this. YouTube landed with this whole new policy. I don't even want to get into it because it stressed the hell out of me. And I was like, you know what? I'm going to take the positive from this experience and, you know, just keep going. I'm going to keep filming videos for you guys because I love doing it. So yeah, the power of positive thinking, no matter what you are going through, always, always think positively. So yeah, these were my 7 really, really, you know, favorite quotes from Sophia's book that marked me, and I decided to share with you guys. Like I said, 2017 was the year of, you know, queening and slaying here and there. 2018 is the year of girls to become bosses, you know, to be a girl boss. So yeah, thank you for watching this video. If you enjoy watching it, don't forget to click that subscribe button and to give this video a big thumbs up. See you guys in my next video. Bye.